Hi, I'm DJ, presenting our work on smart work-based deep learning approaches for sound awareness. Sound recognition is at the heart of many modern AI systems. Our past work, Home Sound, investigated sound classification for accessibility, that is to support DSS users in the home. However, while the watch was used as a feedback device, as with most prior work, the sensing and classification was done on non-portable devices. With the recent shift in AI towards mobile-optimized models, it makes sense to explore sound classification for mobile and wearable devices as well. Indeed, the recently released iOS 14 has incorporated sound recognition into consumer smartphones. But this release is closed source, and the implementation and evaluation details are unknown. In this work, we report on two studies, a quantitative examination of four lightweight deep learning models to classify sound on low resource devices, and a qualitative evaluation of a smartwatch-based sound awareness app called SoundWatch with 8 DSA participants. A recent study with 201 DSA users showed that smartwatch was the most preferred device, even more than smartphone, for sound feedback. Let's go through each study in turn. Study 1. The goal of the first study was to conduct a performance evaluation of four deep learning sound classification models across four device architectures. We downloaded three lightweight image classification models for small devices. These models were recently released in January 2020 and include MobileNet, Inception, and RustNet Lite. We also used a quantized version of the model from a home sound work, which we call VisuDelight. To compare with prior approaches in sound classification, we also evaluated a full VGD model for non-portable devices. Four device architectures were examined: Watch Only, Watch Plus Phone, Watch Plus Cloud, and Watch Plus Phone Plus Cloud. For all our experiments, we used a commercially available smartwatch and smartphone. Let's quickly discuss what we found. While direct comparison to past work is challenging, we found that the best classification model performed similarly to the state of the art for non-portable devices while requiring a substantially less memory. More specifically, the accuracy of a best model was 81.2% for all flying classes and 97.6% for the three highest priority classes when evaluated on a dataset of sound recordings from the field. Among the four models, we also observed a strict accuracy latency trade-off, that is, the most accurate model was also the slower. In terms of the architecture, we found that the two phone-based architectures outperformed the watch-centered design in terms of CPU, memory, battery usage, and the end-to-end latency. To complement this quantitative experiment, we built and conducted a qualitative lab evaluation of a smartwatch-based sound awareness app called SoundWatch with 8 DSA participants. First, a brief description of SoundWatch. SoundWatch is an Android-based app designed for commercially available smartwatches that informs the user about three key sound properties: sound identity, loudness, and time of occurrence, through customizable sound alerts using visual and vibration feedback. SoundWatch offers support for four device architectures with a deep learning model running on either the watch, the phone, or the cloud. We designed our sensing pipeline to protect user privacy. SoundWatch processes the sound locally on the watch or the phone, and in the case of the cloud-based architecture, only upload the non-reconstructable MEL spectrogram feature. Now let me describe its evaluation, that is, the study 2. The goal of the study 2 was to gather user feedback on a system result and the SoundWatch app. We recruited 8 DSA participants, 3 women, 3 men, and 2 brown members. The procedure included a campus walkthrough with the SoundWatch app in 3 contexts: a lounge, a lab, and a bus stop. After the walk, we performed an interview on the experience and other technical considerations, that are the desired accuracy, latency, trade-off for deep learning models, and the thoughts related to privacy and resource consumption for the four possible architectures, the virtually workplace phone, workplace cloud, and workplace front cloud. We found that all participants generally appreciated SoundWorks across all three contexts, reaffirmment, first, path, sound awareness work. However, we also observed several misclassifications, especially outdoor, due to the background noise. For accuracy latency trade-off, participants wanted minimum delay for urgent sound, such as the car horn, in order for them to take any required action, and the maximum accuracy for non-urgent sound, such as the speech, to not be unnecessarily disturbed. Finally, participants selected workplace phone as the most preferred device architecture because compared to the cloud-based architecture, it was more private and versatile, no internet connection was required, and compared to the watch only, it was faster. In reflection, we come back to a research question. How well does the smartwatch-based sound classification tool need to perform to provide value? Our findings show that this is a complex question that needs further study. One way to explore this question is to release SoundWorks to the public, much like what Apple did with the iOS 14, and study the actual field usage. However, this approach also introduces ethical concerns if the user's private data is being recorded, and also a safety concern if the app failed to recognize a critical sound, let's say a fire alarm. But increasing transparency by allowing the user to view the collected sound data and by letting them know that the app could fail at any point may help. Another idea is to increase the perceived accuracy by exploring showing multiple portable sounds. For example, if the system fails to recognize between a microwave or a dishwasher, one of the two both instead of showing the most probable sound as in a design. We can also explore end-user customization. While installing the app, each user could select their desired sound, and the app could dynamically fine-tune the model based on the sound selected. Finally, future work could give the option for the participant to train their own sound, much like what Jason Wu and the team at CMU did for one-shot interaction. Of course, this training may be tedious and difficult if the sound itself is inaccessible to DHS people. In conclusion, I'd like to say that SmartWatch offers a myriad of possibilities for DHS users and beyond. Please refer to the paper for more interesting ideas to explore for SmartWatch-based sound feedback. Thank you.